What's up, YouTube? Today, I want to give you my highly requested curly hair routine for a stretched out but super defined wash and go. Beginning with one of my favorite co-washes by Diva Curl, their Decadence No Poo. I will work this into my scalp to make sure that it's nice and clean. And then from there, I'm gonna let the water run down the length of my hair to carry down that product to make sure that it gets clean without being oversaturated or using too much product. Next, taking their amazing smelling One Condition conditioner, I will work this into the entire length of my hair, making sure that it gets nice and detangled, and then I am going to section it off into little twists to make sure that it doesn't get tangled up in the process of deep conditioning my hair. Now, usually I'm going to use a different deep conditioner than this, but today, for the purposes of this video, I wanted to use it as my deep conditioner as well, which is totally fine. Does an amazing job. After getting your hair nice and conditioned, I go ahead and put my hair up in a shower cap before using one of my favorite deep conditioning products called the Hot Heads Deep Conditioning Cap. So this product is awesome because all you do is pop it in the microwave for 1 minute on one side, another minute on the other, and then if you want to put it in for a third minute, you can totally do that to get it nice and hot. And this is basically your replacement for a hooded dryer, so instead of sitting down and playing Candy Crush for 30 minutes to an hour, you can do your thing, let your hair deep condition, and then rinse it out. Then I will take a t-shirt and start blotting away. Now the reason I use a t-shirt instead of a towel is because I want to minimize frizz, so this does a good job at collecting a decent amount of water while not getting my hair too frizzy. And then using my favorite kinky curly leave-in conditioner called Not Today. I absolutely love this stuff. If you haven't tried it yet, it is bomb. It does the best job at detangling your hair. So I will section my hair out as I detangle and work this through. And from time to time, you probably won't see it in this section, but I will add a little bit of oil sometimes if my hair's in need of some extra moisture. So next, I will part my hair the way that I want it to fall before I begin working in doing my style. Now, sectioning my hair off again, I am going to start with a small section that I want to get wet, and not too wet, but moisturized enough where it's going to hold product and also really have a defined curl pattern. So using my favorite, and I swear to you, I love this stuff so much. The UB Natural Curl Shaping Custard does a great job at defining tighter curl patterns. So using this with the Eco Styler is really great for that 3C, 4A, and even into the 4B and 4C. Just does a really great job at elongating your curls. So I work both of these through my hair. And then I scrunch from the bottom up to make sure that it's nice and defined. And then to avoid having too much shrinkage, which I still have a lot of it, I use these butterfly clips to clip down my roots. And this really, really helps with stretching out my hair a little bit more so I don't have too much shrinkage once my hair dries. So once again, I'm scrunching from the top, making sure that there's no frizz before I lock down my roots. And then move on to the next section. So running it back, I put my cream on there, work it through with my fingers, use some gel to lock in the cream. Get it nice and saturated, and then I scrunch. And clip down those roots for minimal shrinkage. You'll You'll notice that there's very little frizz as I'm styling my hair, because if you do see even just a little bit of frizz as you're styling because you haven't worked through your products enough or haven't put in enough moisture, then there's a good chance that you're going to have a lot of frizz once your hair dries. So making sure you work those products through the first time is going to ensure that your hair is nice and defined once it dries. Now for this top part, you can style this however you want to. This is personally how I like my hair to fall. The good thing about this method is that you're basically giving yourself a lot more control over how your hair is gonna fall too. So if your hair normally sticks up and you feel like you don't have too much control, this is gonna let you have the part that you want to. So if you wanna clip down even more, if you have extra shrinkage, then you can definitely do that. But I think that this gives me a good mix of nice full hair without it being too big on day one. And this is pretty much it. So now I know that my hair is going to be laid the way that I like it to. And next, I just have to let it dry. So you can absolutely let your hair air dry, but when you're in a rush, like I usually am, I like to give it a little bit of a faster pace by using my diffuser. So I take my diffuser on the cool setting mixed with the warm setting, and I will just go all the way around to give my hair a little bit of definition, not blowing it around too much with this diffuser. Using this method with the butterfly clips, you want to make sure that you are paying close attention to the top of your hair. Since your hair is kind of piled on top and doesn't have as much room to breathe, you'll just use your diffuser to kind of apply heat a little bit more in that area to make sure it's nice and dry. And then once you remove your butterfly clips, you can make sure to diffuse it the rest of the way, and you are all good to go. Voila, you're done. Nice, super defined curls. Now, I love this style so much and want to make sure that it lasts as long as possible. So to maintain it, you can usually stretch it out about 3 to 4 days before it starts to get really frizzy. But I use 2 pineapples when I'm wrapping my hair for bed and use a silk scarf to go around the sides of my head to make sure that I don't get any frizz while I'm sleeping. The reason why I use 2 pineapples is because I don't want to stretch the back of my curls too much just by doing one big ponytail at the top. And that will allow me to have hair that looks like this for a good few days. Now, obviously, you want to pick that thing out to get all the volume that you want to. And then you are good to go. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, make sure to leave comments below and give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you guys very soon.